Hello dear friends, because many of you have asked me in the comment section to create a tutorial on downloading and watching recordings from Jortan cameras and other surveillance cameras that work with the Yosee app, I will now present the steps to follow. If you enjoyed this clip and found it helpful, don't forget to give it a like and subscribe for free to this YouTube channel. On the channel you'll find other interesting and useful do-it-yourself tutorials. First, I need to mention that in the description of this clip and at its end, you will find the video about how to install Wi-Fi Jortan surveillance cameras and how to install the apps for both smartphones and computers. Firstly, you'll need to have the CMS client application installed on your PC. In the installation tutorial, you will find where to download it, how to install it, and how to log in. I also need to specify that when logging in on the computer, you will be automatically logged out of the app on your phone, so you will have to re-enter your username and password. Let's open the app. Here is the interface. It closely resembles that of cameras connected to a DVR. As I showed you last time, to view real-time recordings, you just need to drag the names you assigned to each camera into one of the screen compartments. There are many options here that you can explore on your own. You can also watch in full screen mode. Now, to download the recordings, you need to go to the playback menu. Where it says record file type, you'll need to select remote record files. And then choose the camera you're interested in. I have four cameras installed, so I will just select one. Here, you'll need to enter the time interval for the recordings you're interested in. At the top, enter the start date and time, and just under, enter the end date and time. I'll enter the desired interval and click on search. Below, you'll see the list of recordings from this period. Each recording is 1800 seconds, so 30 minutes. As you can see, the recordings are ordered chronologically. At the bottom, you have the option to select all recordings, or you can individually select only those within the desired time interval. I'll choose, let's say, these three recordings. Then click on download, and the download of all selected 30-minute clips will start. On the right, you'll notice the download progress in percentages. It will take some time, so I will skip this part. Once the clip reaches 100%, you'll find them in the C, folder CMS files, videos, and download. Each camera will have a file here with the downloaded recordings. Unfortunately, the file does not have the exact camera name, but rather these numbers. Now that we've solved the issue of downloading the recordings, all that remains is to view them. I will show you two methods. The first and simplest one is to view directly in CMS. Go to Open File, navigate to the folder where the recordings were downloaded, and open the video. Below, you have the commands to view the clip. If you want to watch another clip, go again to Open File and select the other one. The second method, a bit more complicated, is to view the recordings directly in VLC if you have it installed. If not, you can find it online for free. I'm showing you this because VLC has more options for viewing a clip than the CMS application. If you try to watch the clip in VLC with the basic settings, it won't work, as you can see here. Most surveillance camera recordings in general, not just these, have a special format that doesn't run on any player. Therefore, you need to go to Tools, Preferences, select All for all the settings. And that demoxes, choose the H265 module. Now you can open any of the recordings without any issues. Don't forget to reset the settings after you're done. To log out of CMS, you'll need to enter the password again. If you have learned these steps, you'll be able to download and view recordings from any DVR. I figured this might be useful if you want to watch the recordings much faster than on your phone, or if you need recordings to hand over to authorities or other who might request it. As I mentioned at the end of the clip, you have the card with the tutorial for installing Wi-Fi cameras and another tutorial that might interest you. If this video was helpful, please press like and subscribe. It's free, and this way the channel will be better promoted by YouTube's search algorithm.